there's so many things to worry about when you play those guys. They've got, you know, pros down low that can score. They've got guys that make threes. They beat you off the dribble. I mean, you just try to defend them as best you can, make them take a tough shot. You know, sometimes in this league, that's not good enough. Guys make tough shots. You know, it's funny. You know, I go back and watch the film. Florida State probably made three, Phil Kofer especially made three shots that were just incredibly difficult shots down the stretch. And you look back at it, and our guys guard him as well as you can guard him. Guy makes a big time play. That'll happen on Sunday. They're going to have guys that, you know, are big time players, and they make guarded shots. But, you know, the hardest part of that is you got to have the resolve and the mettle to go back out there and fight again. And that's what we'll try to do.
Brad, you talked about the guys have done well when faced with adversity. Mm-hmm. Do you worry about a tipping point where, you know, they get piled on and piled on?
Yeah, I hope not. I don't think so. I mean, you know, you just want your guys to go out and compete, play as hard as they can, and do what you practice. And, you know, we had some breakdowns in that, certainly, in our last game, and that's what cost us. But, you know, that's why I keep coming back to the word approach. I want our approach to be good. You know, our mental focus, our approach to practice, you know, the spirit of this team has been really good throughout the season. And, you know, we're certainly severely challenged with Dante's injury. And, you know, with Shelton's situation, it'll be another difficult factor. And, you know, our guys just need to buckle down, and we need to practice well and get our minds right and get a plan together and go try to execute.
You talk about guys having to step up, other guys on scholarship. Who specifically fills in at that point guard spot?
Well, Clyde's a guy who'll get a good bit, but we, you know, we'll have the luxury of moving different guys around. You know, Scott Spencer and AJ certainly could see more time than they've seen. You know, those guys, they won't play the point, but they might get more touches. Marquise can play some point for us. Gabe handles the ball well enough to be back there and do some things. You know, so we'll, you know, not everything we do is pure single point guard. We have multiple ball handlers handle it. You know, you saw some of that in the last game, and that'll continue. So, you know, we just got to figure out some ways. We might have to tinker a few things, but we'll work on that if we need to.
On TV, Shelton's injury, his situation, it looked pretty scary. You know, just, I assume that you've talked to him. How are his spirits right now? How is he?
Yeah, his spirits are okay. Like he, you know, I haven't seen him yet today, but yeah. I was with him yesterday when the doctors were with him. And, his spirits were good. I mean, he's, you know, he still wasn't all the way, you know, back normal. But he was doing okay for a guy that's been through a lot. And, you know, this won't be easy. But, you know, he's a good kid. He'll be fine eventually.
Connell seemed to be a little bit more aggressive in the first half tonight, looking for the three.
Some of it was just the way the game's played. We, you know, we did one thing for him and got him a shot. And then, you know, the way the game was played, he found himself open, and our guys got him the ball in a couple situations. And, you know, we're not going to tell Mark not to shoot. I mean, that's what he does. And if he's got an open one, we want him to shoot it, and he did. And second half, he didn't play quite as much, didn't have as many opportunities. But it was mostly out of, you know, the way that Florida State was guarding.
But he shoots around 50% from out there. Is that something that you'd like to see more often than that?
You know, some of the reason he shoots 50% is because he takes the right shots. I think sometimes that's a big factor. You know, I think everybody, you know, then you see guys who are asked to do more and who end up with the ball at the end of a shot clock, and their percentages are lower, but it's because they're forced to take some tough shots, and that happens to a couple players on every team every year. You know, so I think Mark's percentage is high because he shoots the right shots, and that's what we want him to do.